Siamo al Miami Yacht Show, un salone che negli anni ha cambiato.
This is the Miami Yacht Show, and it has changed quite a bit over the years. It started out as a show for the second-hand market and brokerage, but it has become a real exhibition that shares the week with the Miami International Boat Show, the salon dedicated to smaller boats and fishers.
L'anno scorso era laggiù in fondo.
Last year it was over there, on Collins Avenue, Miami Beach. It has been moved close to the Marriott Hotel for logistical reasons, which is one of the city's reference points.
Ci sono tanti espositori italiani che stanno vivendo un momento.
There are a lot of Italian exhibitors who are doing really well in the American market at the moment, thanks to our design. But the solid industrial approach counts too.
L'America si conquista con tanti elementi. Intanto per noi è il principale mercato in cui vendiamo, quindi un mercato importante. I fattori sono molteplici.
It takes several angles to be successful in the American market. It's our main market, so it is important for us. There are various factors, but I have to thank the far-sightedness of my father, who came over to America in the 1980s. That was important and very courageous and has helped us a lot. The idea of branching out from Italy and Europe back then, across the ocean, means that we have been able to open a company over here. We have a presence in Florida with a spare parts warehouse, direct assistance, all the things you need in order to win over a difficult market. Maybe the most difficult in the world, the most demanding, that's for sure. It's not just product that counts, but the service that comes with it. So, we have benefited from that. And then the Americans love the Made in Italy label, which is what we stand for, of course, with the best of designs, glamorous boats. The Americans say Azimuth is sexy, just to tell you what some of them think. And you can see it in the type of dealers that we have. Marimax is a powerhouse. It's quoted on the New York Stock Exchange and has stores all across the USA. So to sum up, the American market is very rewarding, even if it is very demanding.
America direi sempre bene, questo nuovo salone di Miami che dopo 30 anni ritorna.
America is always great, and it's great to see this new salon in Miami return to where it was 30 years ago, before Collins Avenue. We've invested 100 million euros in the past 2 years, 60 in the new production facilities, new factories, bought up boatyards in La Spezia, and about 40 million in new products. We've concentrated really hard on new product, which has brought some really great results, like the SX line, the asymmetric 100 footer, the 52 meter boats. They've all been very successful in the market. So we've invested a lot in terms of time and money, and we've had a good return too. In closing up 2018, the company will have brought in between 450 and 460 million worth of revenue.
Nei primi mesi del 2019 abbiamo anche riorganizzato l'azienda dal punto di vista manageriale con l'entrata di Carla De Maria come CEO di Blue Gave.
The beginning of 2019 has seen a managerial reorganization of the company with a new CEO for Blue Game, Carla De Maria, who will look after the development of all new models that aren't San Lorenzo. And then there's Ferruccio Rossi, our new CEO. I will take care of the strategic areas, the product, communication and new ideas. Meanwhile, both Carla and Ferruccio will be more operative in the two areas of business. Ferruccio for San Lorenzo and Carla for the non-San Lorenzo business.
Il mercato americano dà segni di vita importanti, anche se l'incertezza sulla geopolitica.
The American market is showing some significant signs of life, even if the geopolitics and customs duties are still an unknown between China and Europe at the moment, which keeps clients a little on the cautious side. But I have to say that things are going well for the Ferretti Group. They're how we expected them to be.
Abbiamo venduto la costruzione 141, è un CRN 60 metri, tutto in alluminio veloce, di più di 1000 GT ed è il primo venduto per la brand CRN in America nella sua storia, quindi per noi è un passo fondamentale.
We have sold the 141 build, the 60-meter long CRN, all aluminium, fast, and it is the first one we've ever sold in America for the CRN brand. So you can imagine how exciting that is for us. It has opened up the American market, well, the North American market, definitely through the owners, even if they're a very private family with influential friends, but also through the boat, as it will be a fast boat cruising at a minimum of 21.5 knots, even with a full load. These boats will be catering for the American market and everything it wants, from speed to volume and stability too. There will be draft water too, though.
Allora, se parliamo di americano inteso come Stati Uniti d'America, è molto differente dal punto di vista layout. Amano e prediligono cucine aperte da usare con la famiglia o anche non da usare.
So if we talk about American, as in the United States of America, it is very different from the layout point of view. They prefer, well, love, open kitchens, where everyone can be together. Actually, it might be that they don't even use it, but they like the idea of a kitchen in the living room where they can maybe have breakfast or just see it as a place to hang out. On the other hand, the cabins are more or less similar, even if they favor full beam cabins on the lower deck and a master on the main deck. For everything else, they like using their boats the way we do, out in the fresh air. They like open spaces. Well, they like closed spaces too, so you need to be careful with the air conditioning and play around a bit with these inside-outside areas. It may be what they call al fresco dining. It's exactly a year since the launch of the first Pardo 43, that was Miami 2018, and today I think I can say they've stayed the course. They've sold 7 boats in just 1 year. We're increasing our presence, we're developing the dealer network, and the public response has been more than positive. So the expectations are there, and it'll continue to grow. We're in development with the new Pardo 38 that we'll present at the next Cannes Salon. That means both an inboard and outboard version. We've realized that today's client wants a more adaptable boat, which first and foremost is easy to use, has a lot of outdoor living space, and can be taken out without having to have a skipper.
I cantieri sono cantieri di barche importanti, sono tutte quante presenti e quindi è l'occasione.
All the important boatyards are here, so it's a good time to show our products. So we're here with the new line of stabilizers, the new proportionally brushless propellers. These are the products that draw the most interest, and we've had very positive reaction because of them. Our stabilizer is different from anything you find commercially nowadays. It revolutionizes the concept of stabilization and really makes onboard installation easy.
Rispetto solo a 10 anni fa, l'armatore era completamente all'oscuro.
Even just 10 years ago, the boat owner was usually completely in the dark, having to trust everything to the advice from the installer, the seller, or boatyard, or whatever. Nowadays, though, everything has evolved. The owner can play a part as they want, even on the technical side of the product, making decisions, choosing. Which is nicer for us, more interesting, because there's a rapport with people who actually use the boat. Our philosophy is to make things simple. Easy to use.
Al Miami Yacht Show, come in tanti saloni mondiali.
At the Miami Yacht Show, like many other boat shows around the world, the Italian names, our boatyards, are high profile. What are our strengths and weaknesses in the American market?
Beh, ovviamente i nostri punti di forza sono la grande capacità di innovare, di fare design, di fare tecnologia. Abbiamo degli importanti esempi.
Well, obviously, one of our strengths is how we innovate. We're very good at the design too, plus the way we develop technology. We have some important examples in the Magyar market where we are a market leader, where we are all respected, but we are doing pretty well in the small boat sector too, particularly with ribs, where again, we've brought something new to the market. Our weakness? I would say it's our inability to create systems, be united, work together. But I hope this will be sorted out in the near future, because as Italians, when we need to, we know how to get together and work together.
Talking about Benetti, this is a market that has always been good for us. There was a video a few months ago, for example, that shows you what sort of presence we have over here. In November, three 60-metre-long boats left Livorno at the same time, three Benettis. It was a wonderful, gorgeous day, all setting off for the States, sailing across the ocean to get to their owners here in the States.